guys, what's up? If you're new here, my name is Missy Farrell. I'm an IFBB fitness pro, and this is episode 4 of my How to Make a Fitness Routine 10-part series. As you can see, I got my extensions out, and I got the Jon Snow hair. So, let's get into the video. Got the eye of the tiger, the fire, dancing through the fire, cause I am a champion, and you're gonna hear me roar. I hope you guys have been enjoying my other episodes, and you're practicing and learning some new skills. So today I want to teach you how to do 4 new skills. It's kind of going to add on into the other skills that we've been practicing. So last week we learned how to do a cartwheel. So today I want to teach you how to do a cartwheel onto your bottom. And then we're going to do a teddy bear stand, which is like a beginner kind of headstand move, but it's very awesome in fitness routines because you can transition into other skills like holds. Then we're going to work on our one-arm push-up, and then we are going to do a bridge down. Okay, guys, at the beginning of my episodes, I like to give you a little bit of advice for your fitness routines, whether it's practicing or your first time at a competition. I just want to kind of share some knowledge with you guys, and today I want to talk a little bit about safety. You need to really listen to your body. Make sure you warm up, you're stretching, you're using like mats to practice with. There's things for your wrists called tiger paws, which you can buy on Amazon. Ankle supports, knee pads if you're practicing on a hardwood floor like an LA Fitness or a Gold's Gym. You just want to make sure you're always like taking care of your body, because it just takes like one like hard hit and like it's over. I know for me, like if I'm practicing on a hardwood floor, I like to wear shoes because like I get this issue so bad, like on my foot, on my plantars, and it's just excruciating pain all the time. Ask Matt, he's always rubbing my foot at night. Let's start with the teddy bear headstand. Now, when I teach my like minis in gymnastics how to do this, it's really, let me take you off. We'll go from the front just so you can see the hand placements. I like to make a diamond with my hand, be up on my knees, like kind of sitting on my bottom, and place my hands on the ground. Now, what I tell the kids is you want the top of your head to go into the diamond. As you put your head into the diamond, you want to move your hands out into your peripherals. So let me just show you from the side. So if I'm sitting on my bottom, I have my diamond, I place it on the ground. As I'm lifting my head up to put it down, I'm lifting my bottom up and I'm kind of like going up on my toes and I'm putting my head here and then I'm moving my hands to my peripherals. Just straight in front of my face. When you're going up into your headstand, that you fall either back down and catch yourself on your feet, or you roll. You do like a front roll out of your headstand. You never want to fall into a bridge. You could freaking break your neck. That's like a big no-no. Like when I see little kids doing that, like it's stopped right away, and you grab their feet and you kind of like tuck their head and like show them how to roll. You never want to like just flop over. Okay, so now let's do it. We're gonna go diamond down and up and here. So you can come down into a roll, which is like easier for transitionings. Oops, I just spit everywhere. Yeah, and then you could do like funky stuff with your legs, like this, like splits, and it's a good alternative if you can't do a handstand. It still looks cool. So let me show you front on. All right, so diamond. And roll. Now we're going to be working on our bridge down. And with bridge down, it's the same kind of technique with the diamond, how I like to teach kids. Your feet want to be shoulder width apart. Make sure you warm up too, like your back. Do some bridges on the ground before you start doing this, and some rock and rolls. If you don't know what a rock and roll is, it's this. Step one, feet shoulder width apart. Step two, your hands go up above your head into the diamond. Now what you really want to focus on is you want to push your hips forward and let your hands drop to the ground. When they drop, follow your hands back. I tell the kids, follow the diamond. If you follow the diamond and once it hits the ground, then you're good. You can, you know, you're in your bridge. So, shoulder width apart, hands up, hips forward, and we're looking at our hands. And then just do a rock and roll for your back. Okay, so now we're moving on to our cartwheel to our bottom. Now with this skill, you wanna make sure that you have your cartwheel first. And how I like to end this skill is, I like to end it just kinda like this. So what happens is you use your dominant leg, so mine is my left. And as you cartwheel, you're gonna lift up. It's almost like a one-handed cartwheel. And then your left hand is going to come up and you're going to sit. So I'll do it a little faster. All right, and one more time, a little faster. Now we're moving on to the one-arm push-up. This is one of my favorite skills. So let me show you how I do a one-arm push-up and how most of the girls do it today. So you're going to want to pick your dominant arm. My strong one is my left. And you want your legs to shoot out just like kind of like as if you were in a push-up, but they just come out just a little bit. You can still put your arm behind you and like rest it on your butt or like your leg, but it's not like a chest like illusion kind of thing. It's you're actually like using your chest, shoulder, arm, tricep to do the push-up. So from here, it's down and up. That's freaking hard. Like once I get momentum going though, it's like I can bang them out. But yeah, so we'll try that again. Let me do it from the side for you guys. So again, just really push with your palm, like really focus on bringing it down and driving it up. If you can, like do alternating arms, practice on this side too. Like I can't even, I'm so weak on this side. But I try to do other things with this arm, like other holds. You can do both arms. Show that in your routine because that is like a really hard skill to do. So definitely do that. Okay guys, so we're at the end of the video and I just want to show you all the fitness skills together in a combination so that maybe you can use them in your fitness routine after you practice them. Hope you learned something new and that you can either use this for conditioning or possibly in your fitness routine. If you guys like this video, give me a thumbs up and stay tuned for all of my other shenanigans. Thanks.